So that's that. I mean, apparently I was free to go the whole time once it got cleared up, but here I am. Man, it's been a while since I held one of these.
I'm a band man, count bands, man. Off the kickstand, kick me in the trap with TK47. Hey, don't play with this new trucker for my whip and Yan Diego money.
Alright, well, first and foremost, I want to thank everybody who has given me support in the past few months where I haven't been able to make any videos and the time that I've been dealing with the whole NCAA situation. But I wanted to make this video actually because I wanted to give everybody like the whole rundown of what exactly happened and why I haven't been able to make many videos in the past like 5 or 6 months or so. So what started the whole situation was when I did a video with a kid who used to go to UCF, actually does videos now. I'm not allowed to say his name because that's what got me in trouble, because I did a video with him and promoted his page, which he makes money off of. So technically they called his page a business, which I don't get how they get to call it a business. I guess because you just make money off of it and whatnot. I mean, it's not like he owns YouTube, like, whatever. But even before then, before we did that video, I'd gotten in a little bit of trouble because our compliance office, those are the people that are in charge of like making sure all our players are eligible, all our players are doing the right thing and whatnot. So I'd gotten in trouble with them because nobody's sure if I was making money off of YouTube or not, which I knew to play my cards right because, you know, I do have a scholarship to play football for my university and go to school for free, thank God. But nobody knew that I wasn't making any money because there's no way that anybody can check. So we talked it over with the compliance office and got it straightened out. I had to show them my whole page, how I monetize, if I were to monetize, and show them that every video that I've ever made is not monetized in any type of way. So that's where basically things kind of got cleared up, per se. But a month or two went by and I was talking to my friend and I was like, yo, let's shoot a video together. But he doesn't play football anymore, so he can make money off of his videos. But once I gave him the shout out, that's when everything hit the fan. Both him and I posted the video that we took, and I was on my way back home to my hometown, and I get a call from the compliance office, and they said, yo, right now, we're gonna have to call you ineligible, and now you're under investigation with the NCAA because you promoted a business and that's not allowed. And at that point, my heart dropped. I was so distraught because I've done everything I could to make sure that I was okay, that I get to do what I like while playing football and just show you guys what a D1 athlete's life is like all about. But I slipped up, I guess. So after that whole ordeal happened, I come back from my hometown, back to the university. I get a call from my coach. Now I'm like, oh man, this is gonna not be good. So I pick up the phone. He's like, hey, I need you to come into the office. And then just hangs up the phone. I was like, oh, this is gonna suck. And he rings me out, tells me that I'm not allowed to post on any social media, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube especially, obviously, because that's what got me in trouble. So from that point, I couldn't do anything. I couldn't even post on Instagram. But I mean, I tested the waters. I was like, I post a little bit here, nothing football related, just using Instagram because who's not allowed to use Instagram? I mean, every football player in America uses Instagram, come on. So all of summer goes by, and this is a time where the coaches are all out recruiting, whatnot. They're on vacation. This is technically their time off, but they also get to go recruit and whatnot, I think. I don't know, I'm not a coach. So long story short, we come back for mandatory team meetings, and I'm sitting in the meeting room by myself, and Coach Davis comes up to me. He's like, hey, where you been, man? I haven't seen you on social media at all. Like with this, like with a kind of like laughing face, like I could tell like he was serious about like not seeing me. He's like, yo, what are you doing? Like, don't you make videos? like questioning me about it. So I asked him, I'm like, yo, like, am I good? He's like, I mean, yeah. So that's that. I mean, apparently I was free to go the whole time once it got cleared up, but here I am making another video. So expect to see more. Yeah, that's about it. That's all I really wanted to tell you guys. Oh, I also wanted to give you an update because I've been filming pretty much everything, just haven't been posting everything. So I got a lot of stuff saved up. So I'm gonna be able to make a lot of videos. And plus season and camp's coming up. Finals week is this week for summer. And then we head into camp next week, or probably the week that this video is posted. And I'm gonna have a ton of free time basically, because you know, camp isn't anything serious for a kicker and I don't have any school, so that's always nice. I hate school, but I graduate in December, so I'm living. Alright, well, that's about all I wanted to say. And I wanted to post something because I haven't posted anything in a while, so I'm excited to get back to editing too, so that's gonna be fun. And thank you to everyone that has stuck around with me. I hit 100,000 subscribers, which is something that I never thought was even possible. That was under a year, and I've hardly been able to post anything, which is amazing. So I thank you guys so much. Thank you so much for sticking around, and that's about it. Alright, yo. Pop up at the cup, we get up with ya. Smoke him down like a damn swisher. Up the thought, cause I need my bands bigger. Thought she was a